Good morning. I am Maria Subhashini, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Bharat Institute of Higher Education and Research. The course name is Physicochemical Processes for Water and Wastewater Treatment. Course code is U18PCCE603. The topic is Physical Treatment Principles of Wastewater. First, let us see what are the objectives of wastewater treatment. The wastewater is collected from various households and communities, and they must be ultimately returned to the receiving waters or applied to the land or reused after making it safe for the purpose, ensuring no danger to human health or damage to the environment. The objective of wastewater treatment is to extract and remove various toxic pollutants and toxicants, including suspended and dissolved materials, as well as pathogens present in the wastewater, so that its quality is improved to reach the permissible level of water to be discharged or reused. The degree of treatment required for the wastewater depends upon the characteristics of the raw wastewater and the desired quality of treated water for disposal or reuse, which is eventually governed by state-regulated water discharge standards or water quality standards for recycling and reuse. What is the need for wastewater treatment? When effluent wastewaters are discharged into a river water body such as a lake or a sea or a pond, a number of processes occur, like physical processes, chemical processes, biological processes, and they change the characteristics of the water they are discharged in, which causes loss of the life of the organisms. The extent of damage depends upon the type of pollutant present in the effluent. Non-biodegradable pollutants like mercury are mostly deadly as they accumulate in the aquatic organisms, which lead to the biomagnification process. Large quantity of biodegradable waste can affect the living organisms in the water bodies in which the water is discharged. So what is biomagnification? So biomagnification is nothing but the process in which the harmful effect of the toxic toxins increases in each level of the ecosystem. As the toxicants move from one level of the ecosystem to the other level, they get magnified. So if the number of toxicants in the value is 10 in the first level, when it goes to the next level, it becomes 100. Next level, it becomes 1000. Next level, it becomes 1 lakh. So it magnifies in such a way that the impact is very high. So let us see what are the wastewater treatment processes. So mainly the wastewater treatment processes are technically called as unit operations and unit processes. The treatment units or methods in which the application of physical forces predominate is called as unit operations. And primarily the physical separation of the pollutant occurs in these unit operation processes, like screening, grit chamber for removal of grit, sedimentation process, etc. The treatment units or methods in which the chemical or biological reactions predominate are called as unit processes. In such units, the pollutant is chemically or biologically transformed into usually smaller degradable compounds. Example, biodegradation or chemical degradation steps. Since the municipal as well as industrial wastewaters contain physical as well as chemical pollutants, often a combination of these processes, like the unit operations and unit processes, are required for the complete treatment of the wastewater. There are different stages in wastewater treatment: preliminary treatment, primary treatment, secondary treatment, tertiary or advanced treatment. So what is preliminary treatment? Preliminary treatment is the screening of the large floating material and the removal of the grit material like sand, silt present in the wastewater. So if they are not removed in this preliminary process, they will be causing a huge damage to the different devices and treatment units or pumps which are used in the different levels of the wastewater treatment. What is primary treatment? It is a physical settling of the insoluble solids from a wastewater stream, usually called primary settling or primary sedimentation. What is secondary treatment? The biological treatment system followed by a secondary clarification for the separation of biological solids from the main water wastewater stream is called as secondary treatment process. Tertiary process is the treatment process which follows secondary treatment, usually for the removal of nutrients, high TDS, microbial pollutants, etc. So this shows the wastewater treatment plant, the schematic diagram of a wastewater treatment plant. So we have a primary treatment, so we have secondary treatment, and later it is going to the tertiary process. So first we have the raw sewage entering. So this is the screening process which comes under the preliminary process. Then here we have the comminuter. So comminuter is nothing but the device which converts the large pieces of floating material present in the wastewater into smaller particles. So it crushes or divides the larger particles, it converts the larger particles into smaller particles. That is the comminuter or a grinder. Next comes the grit chamber. So the grit particles like sand, silt or any metallic salts which are present as grit, they can be removed by the grit chamber process. And the grit is separated and it is disposed of separately. Next comes the primary clarifier or the primary sedimentation process. So from the primary clarifier process, the primary sedimentation process starts. So here the water is allowed to stand for some time so that all the suspended solids present in the wastewater are brought down by the force of gravity. And this settled matter is called as the primary sludge. And the clarified water or the clear water stands at the top of the top layers of the primary clarifier. And from there it is pumped and it is sent to the secondary clarification or secondary sedimentation process. This primary sludge is disposed of by sludge treatment. Then comes the secondary process. Usually this is called as the secondary treatment process, or it is called as the activated sludge process, in which the primary clarifier sent effluent goes through this, and in this there is an aeration tank where oxygen is provided so that the microorganisms present in the wastewater are activated and they are made more active by the passage of oxygen. And after that this aerated primary effluent goes to the secondary clarifier. So this secondary clarifier, so this is the second step of secondary sedimentation. Here also the sludge gets deposited at the lower layers of the clarifier or the sedimentation tank, and part of this activated sludge is returned back to this aeration tank. Then after the secondary clarification process is over, the secondary effluent goes to the disinfection process or the advanced tertiary processes for wastewater treatment. Next, we'll come to the primary sedimentation. In primary treatment, suspended solids and floating materials are removed. Effluent passes through a screen in which the certain materials like wooden pieces, plastic, paper, floating debris are removed. Then the effluent is passed through a chamber known as the grit chamber. Fatty and oil substances can be removed by the flotation method in order to trap fatty and oily substance. An instrument called as a centrifugal separator is provided in this process. The fatty substances are sent outside and the clean water remains in the center of the cyclone, which is an integral and interior part of the centrifugal separator. The water is passed in the settling tank, in which the water remains for a long time, in which the suspended particles are settled down. This process is known as the sedimentation process. So the primary sedimentation is the main process which is going to occur in the primary treatment. Okay. And this removal of this solid and floating material like wooden pieces, plastic, all this will come under preliminary treatment. The grit chamber also comes under preliminary treatment. Sedimentation can be accelerated by adding chemical substances like coagulant, alum. Some small particles can be separated by flotation method In this method, bubbles of air pass through the bottom of the tank and small particles come in contact with the bubbles and come out of the surface of the water. Colloidal particles can be removed by flocculation and precipitation process. So the first process or the preliminary process of wastewater treatment is screening. Screening is the first unit operation in wastewater treatment plant. A screen is a device with openings generally of uniform size used to retain suspended or floating coarse materials like cloth pieces, wood leaves, plastics, rags, papers, etc. found in the influent wastewaters from different industries. These materials must be removed at the beginning of the treatment process. Otherwise, they would damage subsequent process equipments like pumps, valves, pipelines, impellers, thereby reducing the overall treatment process's reliability and effectiveness. So this picture shows two different types of screen. So you can see these, this is one type of screen which is inclined at an angle. Depending upon the quantity of wastewater coming, depending upon the place where the wastewater treatment is going to be conducted, and also depending upon the constituents of floating matter which is going to enter this screen. So this is inclined at an angle. This is one type of screen, and you can see this some materials are already present in this which have been screened and removed from the wastewater. This type is stepped type of screen. So this also depends upon the topography of the place of location of the wastewater treatment plant. So from which place the wastewater is going to enter the screen and to which place it is going to travel. So that depends, depending upon that, the type of screen is selected. So here also you can see cloth materials, paper, plastics, so all of these have been screened in this type of screen. So all these will be removed from the wastewater, and the wastewater will pass through the screen and it will go to the next process, the grit removal process. What are the features of a screen? The screening element may consist of any of the following: parallel bars or rods, gratings, wire meshes, perforated plates. The openings are usually rectangular or circular, however, they could be of any shape. So depending upon the size of the opening, the screens can be coarse, medium or fine. So here you can see. So the screen is present inside an enclosure, and the wastewater is allowed to pass through this. So you can see small paper materials, rags, cloth materials, etc. are screened on this inclined screen. So here the wastewater comes here through this and enters the screen. Here a pump is provided to pump the water to enter into the screen. So this shows the bar screen, configuration of a bar screen. Here this screen is inclined. So A represents the screen, bar screen. B represents the pipe which allows the water to pass through this, and C represents the bypass pipe. Next, we'll see about the comminuting device or the grinder. A comminuting device is a mechanically cleaned screen that shreds the coarse solid materials and returns these materials into the wastewater flow. These devices cut the retained solids, thus enabling them to pass along with the sewage. The solids from the comminuting device or the grinder may lead to more scum in the digester. They are recommended for smaller sized sewage treatment plants of up to 1 million liters per day. So you can see this is the comminuter. So here is the influent wastewater containing these larger solid particles. So when this enters, you have a rotating cutting screen in this. You can see this is the screen. So when it enters, it is cut into smaller pieces. So you can see this is converted into small particles. And after that, it passes through the next pipe to the next subsequent treatment plant. So next process in preliminary treatment is grit chamber. Grit chamber is usually the second unit operation intended to remove grit from the wastewater. Grit is the heaviest material in the wastewater and includes substances such as sand, coffee ground particles, gravel, cinders, etc. The specific gravity of the grit is usually between 2.4 to 2.65, much higher than the organic solids. Grit removal is necessary to protect the moving mechanical equipment and pump elements from abrasion and abnormal wear and tear. Removal of grit also reduces the frequency of cleaning of digesters and settling tanks. Grit is non-putrescible and possesses higher hydraulic subsidence value than organic solids. Therefore, they can be separated from the organic solids by differential sedimentation in grit chamber and sedimentation tank. So, for sand, coffee ground, gravel particles, cinder particles from different types of industries, like your thermal power plants or your boilers or steel manufacturing industry or coffee processing industry, or it can be from a cement manufacturing industry, or it can be from a concrete manufacturing industry. So all these are examples for grit. So if the grit is not removed, they will cause, surely cause abrasion in the mechanical equipments and pumps, and will cause total damage to the pumps. So this shows a grit chamber. So here you have the grit chamber with a slope at the bottom so that the grit can be easily deposited at the bottom. So here you have the inlet. So the fat, soil and grease are on the top. The grit particle, you can see all these black particles are the grit particles, and the compressed air is usually provided. If required, compressed air is provided to initiate the grit removal process. So all these grits get deposited at the bottom and they are removed separately. So this is your grit chamber. So this, so after that the clear water goes through the outlet to the next process, like the primary sedimentation process or the primary treatment process or the primary clarification process. So these yellow particles, can you see, these are all moving up. So they move and they settle on the top as fats, oil and grease. So why is air required, compressed air required for this process? So it accelerates the process of settling of the grit and moving up of the fats, oils and grease to the top layers, so that the grit can be easily removed from these fatty particles. So grit removal is both qualitatively and quantitatively depending upon the types of street surfaces encountered, the relative areas served, the types of inlets and catch basins, climatic conditions, the construction and condition of sewer systems, sewer grades, the ground and the ground characteristics, the soil characteristics, groundwater characteristics of the industrial waste which come along them, the amount of stormwater diverted through the overflow points, the social habits, the night soil and other solid admitting to the sewers through dumping chutes or tail depots. The grit is usually limited to the municipal wastewater, and generally it is not required for industrial effluent treatment plants except some industrial wastewaters which may have grit. So industrial wastewaters may not have grit because they are process specific. Okay, so grit is usually the sand or gravel. So there is very less chance of sand or gravel to be present in industrial wastewaters. Hence, grit removal chamber is not at all required for an industrial effluent plant. So it is required for your municipal wastewater, which treats storm water, normal household water, or water from any water source. So sedimentation process, settling down of suspended particles at the bottom of the wastewater chamber is called as sedimentation. This process is also known as clarification. In this process, water is collected into a big pond. Slowly, impurities are settled down by the gravitation process. The process of sedimentation can be accelerated by adding alum. It is called as sedimentation aided by coagulation. The main objective of sedimentation are the suspended and the colloidal impurities are separated in sedimentation tank by gravitation. It reduces the heavy sediment load before treating water for other purposes. The main principle of sedimentation is to allow water to rest or flow at a very slow velocity so that heavier particles settle down due to gravity. The process of settling of particles mainly depends on the velocity of flow, size, shape and specific gravity of particles and the viscosity of liquid. The velocity of water decreased by increasing the length of the flow. This principle is used in the process of sedimentation. Size and shape of particles are increased by formation of precipitates because of the addition of coagulants. So next, what is a skimming tank? So it is used for the removal of fats, waxes, soaps, etc. The fats, waxes, fatty acids, soaps, minerals and vegetable oils present in the wastewater are collectively called oil and grease. As oil and grease are lighter than water, they are normally separated by natural flotation. The bubbles of air are passed on to the top of the tank and the floating matter rises and remains on the surface of wastewater, which can be separated easily. So a skimming tank is very much necessary for every water treatment or wastewater treatment plant to remove the oil and grease present. Next, we have to see about coagulation, which is going to aid in the sedimentation process. In plain sedimentation, the heavier particles settle down easily, but fine particles may take many hours or sometimes days to settle down. The colloidal particles, which are finely divided particles of size finer than 0.0001 micron mm size, carry electrical charges on them. The water possesses color, which is mainly due to the colloidal matter and dissolved organic matter in water. The turbidity in water is mainly due to the presence of very fine particles of clay, silt and organic matter. Sedimentation alone is not sufficient to remove all these suspended and colloidal particles. The process of coagulation is very much needed to remove the colloidal particles from water. Coagulation is the process by which certain chemical agents are mixed with the water. Then the colloidal and suspended particles are agglomerated and form insoluble metal hydroxide chemicals called as flocs. Coagulation is adopted when turbidity is more than 40 ppm. By coagulation process, the fine particles are removed rapidly and turbidity is reduced to about 20 ppm. The most common coagulants are aluminium sulfate, chlorinated copper, ferrous sulfate, lime, magnesium carbonate, polyelectrolytes and sodium aluminates. So the most common one is alum or aluminium sulfate. Flocculation is the agglomeration of destabilized particles into microflocs and after into bulky flocs, which can be settled as macroflocs. The addition of another agent called as flocculant aids in the promote the formation of floc and also to be helpful in the removal of sludge as floc. So this shows the coagulation process. The coagulant is added. Impurities, they react with the coagulants. Coagulant forms precipitate, trapping the impurities. Then precipitate and trapped impurities settle at the bottom as sludge. So this also shows the coagulation tank with flash mixing, where the coagulant is added. Then comes the flocculant, where there is no mixing. Then there are three processes: decantation process, flotation process, filtration process, by which this flocs formed are removed and they are converted into treated water. Next, let us see about the adsorption process for wastewater treatment. Adsorption is typically used for removing a wide range of compounds from industrial wastewater, especially implemented for the removal of micropollutants, non-degradable organic compounds and few metals from wastewater or source waters. Adsorption is a mass transfer process which involves accumulation of pollutants at the solid surfaces, thereby leaving the water phase. So this shows the adsorption process. So there is diffusion to adsorb surface, migration into the pores of the adsorbent by the contaminant molecules, then monolayer buildup of adsorbent. So the most commonly used adsorbents will be activated carbon, synthetic zeolites, natural clay minerals, silica gel and activated aluminium are very popular polar adsorbents with large affinity for water, normally used to remove water from an apolar medium like silicic acid. There are two types of adsorption. This is option or physical adsorption, which uses the principle of van der Waals interaction, and chemisorption, which uses the gas molecules or atoms being held by chemical bonds to the solid. Example for this is hydrogen is chemisorbed on nickel. So this shows the adsorption on activated carbon. So activated carbon is the best adsorbent. Activated carbon provides a large surface area for water treatment. It has high porosity and extended surface area. Activated carbon filters are efficient to remove organics, metals, chlorine, fluorine, or radon and other micropollutants from water. So these two diagrams show activated carbon arrangement in a filtration unit for the wastewater treatment. So next let us see about the filtration process. Filtration is the most important process in wastewater treatment. It is done to remove the colloidal and suspended matter remaining after sedimentation and to remove bacteriological load. The process of filtration usually consists of allowing the water to pass through a thick layer of sand or porous material which retains the coarse impurities on its surface and in its pores. The apparatus used for filtration is called as a filter, and the porous material that fills the filter is known as the filtering medium. There are different types of filters: slow sand filter, rapid sand filter, gravity type filter, pressure type filter. The filters are of different types depending upon the head required for filtration, rate of filtration, composition of filter media, method and frequency of cleaning of the filters. The most commonly used filter media are sand, anthracite, garnet sand or limonite, and other locally available materials. So let us see about one of the most important filters called as the Tickling filter. So this is the diagram of a Tickling filter. So here you have the rotating effluent distributor. So this is the distributor of the wastewater. So this is the domed enclosure. Then we have the media, then air is supplied. This is totally the Tickling filter unit. Then after that, the treated water comes out and it goes to the next process. And the sludge which is produced is disposed of. So the Tickling filter consists of a bed of crushed stones or pebbles covered with slime, which contains aerobic bacteria, algae, fungi, protozoa, worms, and insect larvae. Sewage is degraded by the aerobic bacteria when it passes through the bed and it is collected at the bottom of the filter. The Tickling filter helps in better removal of organic matter and also keeps the filter moist when the flow rate is very slow. So this shows a typical Tickling filter system. So here you have the water trickled over a tank. So this is your wastewater trickled over bacteria covered media and BOD eaten by bacteria, which eventually dies out and flows out. So oxygen free to flow in the tank. Oxygen supply is there provided. Wastewater is pumped into the tank. And after the filtration is completed, treated water flows to the secondary sedimentation tank and the dead bacteria is removed by sludge. Let us see the principle of Tickling filter. The Tickling filter is an aerobic attached growth biological system. The major components of the Tickling filter are the Tickling filter enclosure tank, the rotary distributor, the filter media, the under drainage system. The filter media consists of crushed stones, gravel and plastic. Then we have the ventilation system. Then we have the biological process which actually occurs. The bacteria is attached to the filter media, forming a biological layer called as a biofilm. The sprinkled wastewater over the filter media forms liquid film, including food and dissolved oxygen. The biofilm absorbs the organic matter and oxidized, producing carbon dioxide, water, NH3, and a new cell. The biological layer consists of aerobic and anaerobic partitions of bacterial layers, and the mass of the biofilm increases, the lower layer will be anaerobic with lower food supply, which will lead to the increase of the attaching force between the biofilm and the filter media. In this case, the biofilm is ploughed out or disconnected and it flows out of the wastewater to the final sedimentation tank where it settles. So this diagram shows a tricking filter, a typical tricking filter. Here you have one. So one is the total tricking filter unit. So two is the full enclosure of the tank. Then we have the different tricking filter layers, which are going to filter the wastewater. Then this, the top position shows the distributary arms of the wastewater. So with this, we come to the end of the topic on physical treatment process for wastewater.